is that I did notice that their coach was calling out a little bit, but, you know, as a coach, you've got to become a vocal leader of the team. You've got to get loud. You've got to be hyped. You've got to be the reason. You've got to be the Mr. X. You've got to do that for your team.
Yeah. And sorry to interrupt you, but do you know who the player was? Which player was actually getting them hyped up? Was that the coach?
No, I believe it was, I actually want to say it was Mortal. I'm not 100% sure. You know, maybe someone in the chat that actually knows the team might know this. But, you know, we're coming down to 28 seconds left. This one is going to... I'm going to take this one away, if you don't mind, Derek. As it is down, and I'm going to be on board with Gardas. Guard's going to be holding this one off with his duo. Nihil's going to pick up a great two piece right there. Swivel going to take him. Guard going to fall and die. That could have been the game for his team. It's 210 to 205, but it looks like his team is going to hold this one off for the last 5 seconds. And there it is. The game is going to be out of reach as Nifty going to pick up the two piece, and shots will be fired. This one's going to go 4-0.
Yeah, definitely. As you said, High Society was actually down for the most part of that game. Started to pull it back, and it was just neck and neck right there. High Society showing their dominance once again in Hardpoint. So next is actually Search and Destroy, I believe, if that's the rotation that we're going in. As you saw, High Society dominated that Search and Destroy the last one we played. They actually won that 6-2. But Abyss right now, they were on top for so much of the game, and I'm not sure what was lacking. It was just such a close game. It just came down to those last few kills who came up clutch.
Yeah, it was really down to a few plays, and I think that last kill had a lot to do with it, on top of not being able to take out that escort drone. And this was one of those maps where solutions were a factor. And that one's going to go to High Society as well, and they're looking at one map away from a nice shutout. And we're going to go into an S&D on raid, evidently.
Yeah, like I just saw in the chat, Volvo's actually the coach. He is Volcat. He said, that's what happened when High Society doesn't play on host. So, bringing in the internet connection, I don't know if you're going to talk about that. There's not much to talk about. It's such a big factor in Black Ops 2 that I've noticed, really compared to other games, like Modern Warfare and all that. I never really played those. I wasn't a big fan of Modern Warfare 2 or Modern Warfare 3. I've always been a Treyarch kind of guy.
And that, sir, is why I think you do drugs.
But, like I said, because World of War was one of my most successful games. Like, I was real good at that. That's the game I played all the time. But I never really considered, even when I just played Black Ops 2 League Play, I never really considered internet as a factor. Like, I've never been that person like, oh my god, he's such a warrior, he has Fios or anything. Like, I don't really see how... I think pros really put their mind too much to it. The way I just play and just do the best I can. Sometimes I finish on top. Someone could have Fios in my game, but I don't know. Like, what is your thoughts on the internet connection? Like, do you think online matters like a lot of pros like say it does?
Oh yeah, online's a factor. I mean, I've been a coach for the last year and a half, and the last 6 months or so, I've kind of stepped away and I've gone into like the management side of like organizations and such. But online is more than a factor. It's a key. And, you know, I think if something doesn't get fixed when we come into COD Ghost, I think your online playstyle is going to be something teams are actually going to start to look at a lot more than LAN experience, because there is a lot of money to be won online. But, you know, I'm going to be on board with Mortal, as Mortal actually watched his teammate die right off the bat, which would have been McKay, as it's going to be down to a 3v4 early on, and it does look like this team from Abyss has locked themselves into a corner, and it's not good for them as High Society has locked him down. But Guard going to go down right there as Swivel finally going to pick up a kill for his team, as I'm going to be on board with X. I've got the hiccups. Exit going to be hanging out, watching the middle with that sniper rifle, and this one's turned out into an all-out sniper fest.
Yeah, definitely. It's currently a 3v3 right now, as you saw. Sick and Guard are actually down for their teams. But it looks like that Abyss is actually going to slowly start to rotate around back to that B-bomb. There is going to be a High Society player in the zigzag who is Nye. Nye's taking shots. They're both just trading right now. But he does get taken out. That B23R is just insane from close range, even sometimes from far. But right now, it is a 3v2 situation in favor of Abyss. Spoke too soon. Nifty is the last player alive for High Society. 1v2 right now. Mortar and Swivel are the last alive. They need to get this bomb down, but it looks like no one's having it. But they do pick up this last kill. Swivel going reckless right there with that B23R picking up this last kill to give them the 1-0 lead in favor of Abyss.
You know, and I think we're finally starting to see that life from Abyss as High Society. Looks like they're not on that throne that they've been on all night. And maybe they're starting to lose a little bit of that momentum after that last close game. But, you know, it's going to be 1-0. One round doesn't really mean a lot. As I do want to hop on board with Nifty, as Nifty is going to be running that AR. You know, I believe he's got a trophy system, red dot, and sniper rifle with the Grizz Cannon. There we go. That's what I wanted to see. As he's going to be hanging out on top, going to let that shot fly into the flower box, as nothing's going to get connected, as guard is slowly going to be creeping onto that bomb site, as it looks like it is going to be a 3v4, as here we go, the onslaught from this Abyss team, as they're going to be pushing from the mid, the side, and the back, as Nifty, though, already on the flank waiting for it, as McKay is just going to pre-fire Nifty around that corner. What a great play by him, knowing that where he was is going to be up to guard in this tiki booth to clutch the 1v2 against Swivel. Is Swivel going to put him in the dirt? And oh my goodness, he just said, "I'm your daddy."
Yeah, definitely. That was a sick quick kill. I wish we could
Swivel's
actually see.
Streaks as well.
Oh, yeah, I wish we could actually see that kill count. I don't think we're able to in the podcast. I'm not sure if
I
it
think
shows.
We will.
I'm not really sure. I never really. Between
job,
games,
Claude.
I think
You're
we do. I'm not
round.
Entirely sure. Oh, yes, we do.
Lordy.
As you see, Swivel going out right here. Just turning season pro. He's like, no, no, no. Boom! What a quick scope right there. Phase up! Someone get this guy in phase. But Swivel right there does have his streaks. Did destroy that trophy system, so he did rack up a few points there. I believe Swivel just has his... Oh, he actually has his Hellstorm and Lightning Strike. So... Getting onto the Hellstorm objective. And Lightning Strike, that is obviously such a big factor in Search and Destroy, especially on a map like this where both bombs are actually outside. So it really opens it up.
And there's the third streak. Yeah. Swivel is...
Yeah, dude. Swivel is going off. 7 kill streak. Yeah, full streaks with a sniper. This guy is just going off. The Beach 3 on secondary. He's actually going to use that Lightning Strike or ping it. Nope, he's actually going to use that Lightning Strike. I would honestly, I don't think I would use it this early in the game, especially with like on a map like this. Like you're only up 2 rounds. What my strategy is really with streaks, I usually save them up until we get further into the round. A Swivel gets another kill with that sniper, absolutely going berserk right now. But like I said, I don't think I would have used the streaks this early. They do go up 3-0, but that's just my opinion.
If Swivel keeps going, someone's going to have to come up and pick my jaw off the ground, because this kid is going huge right now to put it to 3-0. And this is actually amazing. And I don't even know what to say. I think High Society needs to make a change right now, as it looks like Nihil is going to be going right up the middle of the map early on. No one going to be there. We're going to see 3 B-side from this Abyss team perfectly calling that one out, but Nihil finally going to shut Swivel down. And sorry, Swivel, you can't go that big today, as you are 9-1, and you're going to be taking a seat for this round, as Nihil's going to have to protect his teammate, as someone is going to be pushing up on those rocks side down to a 3v3, 1 minute and 2 seconds left to go. I'm not sure what's going to go on right now, as it looks like we're going to see the B push with guard completely destroying McKay right there, as it looks like every time Abyssal's gone down, it's just going to be the end of the round.
Yeah, definitely. It is a 2v2 right now. Nifty does have the bomb. That is actually who I am on board with. His teammate Guard rocking the M82. So Nifty is actually going to get this bomb down right now, but he does not know that they're actually probably going to pinch him. They don't know that he's there. Maybe the person behind is going to get this call out, and that is actually Inspire? No, but his teammate does go down. 1v1 now, Nifty against Inspire. Inspire obviously has the advantage right now up in the bedroom, but let's see what Nifty's going to be able to do here. He pulls a sneaky play and goes to B. It looks like he's definitely going to get this bomb down. He just really juked Inspire on that one, but Inspire does know now that where he is. So it's just a waiting game now. Who's going to make the attack first? But Nifty is just going to look to play this slow as usual. But looks like he may be getting a pro. So he may still have to watch that. But it looks like he is actually going to be taken out. Inspire goes big and clutches this to give them a 4-0 lead. Inspire on a 4-kill streak. And this is just great play right now by Abyss. Abyss really coming out of the Search and Destroy. They're just saying to High Society right now, you guys aren't doing this to us like you did in the last Search and Destroy game, which was completely a blowout.
Yeah, this is getting ugly. And I'm not sure what to say. I think we're seeing a completely different High Society team here. They're not really connecting on their shots like they should be. And you know, I think they just need to slow it down, realize what needs to be done, and I think they'll be all right to finish this up, because I think this could be the comeback that you were talking about in S&D.
Yeah, definitely. So right now, I'm actually still going to stay on board with Inspire. Like he just said, he went big, got that clutch right there. As you see, he's going to be rocking that overkill with the MSMC and the DSR. Kind of a classic thing you see many people use it. As he gets that cheeky hit marker right there.
Did you say cheeky?
Yep, I definitely said cheeky. Lordy. I've been watching Benson. I think I got that from Benson. But anyway, Benson's a great guy. As you see right there, Nye just coming around with that MSMC, putting the full-on rush and taking Inspire out. But I'm just amazed that I said the word cheeky. I mean, I was born in England, but I've never said cheeky in my life.
There's a certain time for everything, son. And that's all we're gonna write on that one. Is High Society finally picking up a round right there, making it 4-1 in favor of Abyss. Is now we're gonna have to see High Society really make some moves and come back here, as I want to be on board with Chance. Chance, the OBJ player for this team, and that's clear. He's been the bomb carrier. He's been the man in the hardpoint the entire time. As one man is gonna go down for Abyss. And here we go. Chance just waiting. He knows someone's going to push. Here comes the Hellstorm missile. And that could be devastating for High Society. Two are going to go down, making it a 2v3 situation. And here we go. Shot's going to be fired. Chance just looking at the wrong time. That's so timing oriented. I feel awful for him right now. But it's going to be up to Nihil to clutch, or Nifty to clutch a 1v3. As Nifty is just going to be hanging out in the top laundry area. Just chilling, you know, not really doing anything too bad. As he will notice one over there in the rocks area. And it shots are going to be fired. Nifty has been spotted, and there it is. He's going to connect on one down to a 2v1, 40 seconds left to go, as the bomb will be in that bottom red area, as there will be another player at the A side. Shots going to fire. Nifty connects on that one. Nifty going, who's your daddy? I am. And 28 seconds left to go. He's going to be rotating through the middle of the map right now, as he is going to have this man come up right behind him. Nifty, turn around, son. Turn around. Turn around. No, Nifty, no. As it looks like Nifty is going to be trying to figure out where he needs to go, and it looks like he's just going to go right to B, which is the smart play. But I do think that Mortal is going to find him just in the nick of time. But no, Mortal could be on the wrong side. Will Nifty get out of it? And yes, Nifty can, but the Mortal is going to pick it up right away. And that was so close to Nifty almost coming up huge for his team, but now it will be 5-1 in favor of Abyss.
Yeah, this is a blowout by Abyss right now in Search and Destroy. Only one round win for High Society, which is kind of strange because we've seen them dominate so much during the game. Maybe like Volz was saying, maybe it is host, but I don't really want to get into that argument. I don't want to start drama with players, like if they're watching this and on Twitter and stuff. So we're just going to kind of get away from that. I'm not really one to
Operation Ready Point.
Deal with the whole drama situation. But that was big plays right there by Mortal as he clutched that. Going up 5-1 right now over High Society. But Nifty right there, that was kind of impressive. Even though he did not get the full clutch, I believe when their players tried baiting with that shot, he just came right out and just slayed. But he just took too much time kind of getting that bomb and getting the plant. He could have gone to A regardless. He wouldn't have had enough time, I think. The kill's being traded right there. Swivel is actually using that war machine right now as he is in the A bedroom. But right now it's a 1v3 guard by himself just getting war machine shots just fired at him nonstop. If guard can go clutch here, this is going to be so big. Let's see. Swivel with that war machine going big.
Nice.
6-1, and Abyss takes this one, trying to stay alive in this series.
Oh my, is Abyssal just going huge and showing that score streaks are the factor. And you know, the last two matches, or the last two games that we've seen, score streaks have been probably the deciding factor, as we are going to be going into a CTF right now, which we saw an absolute domination from High Society last time.
Yeah, definitely. I was just kind of off Travis is looking at Twitter. Just had to tweet out to Benson real quick, see if he'll see it. The fact that I said cheeky, that's just something I've seen him get a lot of jokes when he's casting with Fwizz and everything. But right now, we're just trying to see if Abyss can just keep this alive. As you see, they did actually go big right there, and there comes their coach. Maybe the coach is the issue on this. But who knows? He wasn't in there the whole time. I didn't really notice, to be completely honest.
You know, I mean, they won a map without the coach,
sorry about that.
No comment.
Get anyway. Lost, nasty.
Hey, he's a good guy. Although, I do respect that, man. He does have some crazy stuff. And we're just hanging out, just waiting, as we will be going into a CTF on Slums. And Taylor, I see you in the chat. Did you buy my tie like I told you to? I don't have any style. Taylor went shopping yesterday, and he was supposed to buy me a tie. He didn't buy me a tie. All right,
nice.
That's cool.
Taylor, why would you waste money on a tie, man? I have about 70 hanging
up
in my closet.
UMG. Come on now. Everybody needs a new tie, right?
Oh, man. Guys, we certainly appreciate the support tonight. We got a couple more matches.